Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at three new things that are added to Laravel version 8.70. And also before that, in my previous video, I missed one feature about the Laravel version 8.69.0. So I'll be showing you that first. And then after that, we'll move to 8.7.0. So in the previous version, there was one new thing added to the auth attempt. If you look here in the login request, to authenticate the user, we can use auth attempt over here. And I have used it over here like this. And we can pass the email and password as the first parameter as an array over here like this. But now we can also pass a closure inside the array. So now if we pass here like this. So before that, let me show you some data in the database. So as you can see here, I have some users over here and some of them have verified emails and some of them do not have any verified emails. And I'm just showing you this as an example, but you can use it in any other use cases as well. Like let's say if a user is not subscribed or their subscription has expired, then we can make sure they are not able to log in and store the message accordingly. Before we couldn't just write a where condition whenever user is being logged in, but now we can just do that using a parameter like this. If the user doesn't have a verified email, they will not be able to log in. So here in the database, this admin user hasn't verified the email. So let's try to log in as an admin. So here I'll say admin and I'll add the password. And you can see here these credentials do not match our records. And I know that this is not the correct message, but you can just return the message whatever you want. And in this video, I'm just showing you this new thing that we can add to the auth attempt. Now let's move to the latest version of Laravel, which is 8.70. So the first thing that has been added to the latest version of Laravel is the can method in the route. So if you see here in the route, I have this view category gate. If I show you here in the auth service provider like this, I have defined a gate like this. And before we had to access it like this inside middleware like this. So middleware can view category like this, but now there is a dedicated method for it. So we can just write here can view category like this. And as you have seen here in the auth service provider, if the category ID is 1, then we are only allowing it to view it. Otherwise, we cannot view it. So let's see that in action. Now you can easily see that we can view the category with the ID of 1. Now if I change the ID to 2, then you can see that this action is not authorized. So this is the new method that has been added to the route class. The second thing that has been added is a new JS facade or class, and we can convert any array into the JSON by using that class. So before in the blade file, we had to use @JSON. So let me show you that first. Let me go to the dashboard. Let me show you that how we could do it before and now how we can do it. And I'll also show you the difference like that. Okay. So before we could do, let's say script. And I'll say let data is equals to @JSON. Let's say A equals to 1 and B is equals to 0 like this. And if I just reload over here, and if I show you the source code, you can see here it is shown like this. And in the latest version, we can also do like this JS from like this. So this is the new facade that has been added and you can access it in the blade directly. And if you are just updating from previous version of Laravel to this version, then you have to add this to the config app.php. So here like this, you have to add over here in the aliases array. But if you are directly installing it now, then it will automatically be added. So if I come here in the browser and just reload, you can see here the difference is like this because it will automatically escape all the unwanted string for us. And also if we pass here collection, collect like this, and also here collect, if I just reload over here, then you can see the same results, but the difference is internal behavior. So the this @JSON uses regular expression to evaluate this, but this one uses actual JSON encode. Let's say we want to perform some complex operation inside this, then it will throw an error. But this one will not throw an error over here, okay? So let me remove this now. And the third thing that has been added is the new requests flag when making a model. So here, let's say I want to make a new model, php artisan make model. Now we can easily make the requests for it as well for validation. So we can say here --req_uests request like this, or we can just pass --r like this. And if I hit enter, sorry, the model already exists. So let me just say here, student. And this will only work whenever you are using a resourceful controller. So what you can do is -resourc, or you can just pass here R like this. So they are combined. So if I just hit enter now, you can see here model requests, request and controller created successfully. And if I look here inside this students controller, so you can see here all these four files are created. So inside the students controller, we have all the resources. And if you see here inside the store, we have store student request, and here we have update student request. And if I just show you inside here, you can see this data, and here you can see this plain request class.